Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for today. So another gem of new generation custom ROM in the year of 2025, Infinity X released their latest version 2.7 for all official devices. This time they brought custom GSI build of this version for all the devices. We already reviewed its official build of old version Infinity X 2.6. You can check that from the iCard link featuring OnePlus 12. I tried this custom GSI on my OnePlus 9RT and it's booted successfully. Today in this video, we are going to review all the new changes of new Infinity X 2.7 eligible devices which got this update officially and unofficially. And at the last, we shown what are the bugs if you are using the custom GSI of this build, along with one surprising thing which I found first time using the custom GSI. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. This update is released with the QPR2 source codes. I am using the unofficial Infinity X 2.7 on my OnePlus 9RT. It's same Android 15 build. Security patches of this build are updated with March 2025. Surprisingly, though this is a custom GSI build, but it's booted with its own kernel version 5.4.254, builded with the latest Clang toolchain V11. Now we'll see all the new changes of this update as per the changelog released by the Infinity X team. Google Circle to search is now activated by default in this update. You don't need to update Google application from the Play Store, which we needs to be done in the previous builds of Infinity X. Music playback, which are played within the phone, are now detected by the circle to search accurately, which was buggy in the previous builds. For depth wallpaper, glitches of accessing quick setting panel on the lock screen is fixed now. Messaging application is now updated with the new Google Messaging application which supports the RCS messaging. Infinity team also added Google Clock, Calculator and the Chrome by default in the OS. So now there is no need to download Core G apps in the ROM if you are first time flashing this build. Instead of this, I found some new settings in this build. One of that is the QS panel transition animation. You will find this setting under the Infinity X customization and in QS panel option. Here we will get bunch of the different transition animation styles for the QS panel page. I first time ever seen such customization in the custom ROMs. There are lots of amazing animations are available here, but my favorite is the cube one. In previous generations of the custom ROM, we've seen the QS panel tiles on and off animations, but this QS panel transition page animations looks very nice. Next is the new data users panel. This toggle enables the detailed information of combined data users of your device, which is done by using Wi-Fi and by using the network. To activate this, you need to restart the system via using the advanced power menu after enabling this toggle. This one is also newest feature which did not found in the previous generations of custom ROMs. Except this, all old amazing customizations are available in the Infinity X customization tab, which we already discussed in our old video. You can check those customization in detail through the iCard video link. But in short, most amazing customizations like lock screen, interactive widgets are available and working very well in this ROM. Depth wallpaper feature is available and it's also working well. You can check our video link given in iCard where we've shown how to use this feature in a custom ROM to enable the true depth effect of wallpaper on the lock screen. Except this, we also got all the always on display customization with the new lock screen clock styles which will beautify your device lock screen. We get the true multitasking experience in this ROM like OxygenOS and NothingOS. After this new update, freeform mode of application window is much more smoother now. You can easily minimize and maximize the application windows. You can pin them to the top right corner and can access them back easily now. All the new Google apps, tensor chip spoofing, force 120 FPS and other advanced features are available in the miscellaneous setting and working well. This is new Infinity X 2.7. But if your device is not officially supported and your device didn't have any unofficial support of Infinity X ROM, then don't worry, you can use custom JSA build given in the video description. It's pretty stable, almost everything is working for me on my 9RT device, like Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi hotspot, Bluetooth, GPS, NFC, screen sharing, always on display, etc. Incoming and outgoing calls are also working, but there is one bug that I will tell you soon. All the sensors are working, like gyroscope, light, accelerometer, ear proximity, multi-touch, mic, these are also working well. Google Play Protect is certified, Play Integrity checks are also successful, so you can use all the banking and payment application without issues. And the most surprising thing is that the DRM info security is showing L1, means you can stream Netflix or Amazon Prime at the full HD resolution. This is all happening because device bootloader state is showing locked when I checked its status in a developer option. I don't know it's a spoofing or what, but it's very surprising that how it's possible on the custom JSI or ROM to bypass this state. I didn't know the bootloader state will like this for all the devices, but in my 9RT it's showing bootloader is locked in the developer setting. So what are the bugs for this JSI for OnePlus 9RT? In my device, OnePlus alert slider of OnePlus devices will not work. Fingerprint unlock is also not working, but you can use face unlock. After first boot, you may face misalignment of status bar icon. To solve that, you need to select punch hole cutout, which is available in the display setting. And then in Infinity X customization and under the status bar setting, enable the padding level for the status bar items, as you can check in this video. Only 2G incoming and outgoing calls are working. There is no LTE network is available. View LTE calling is not working for me. Once LTE calling and network issue get solved, this custom JSI can be considered as a stable build to use as a daily driver for all users, like any kind of custom ROMs. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.